Try to play at least one song that might make you happy. We'll see if you recognize this. I've been trying to practice it all week. Woo! Freebird. All right, kids, here comes the first whip crack of the show. It's going to be kind of loud. You may want to plug your ears. I know. This way, free haircuts, free baby sitting, and free vasectomies. I don't know, you need one? Dude, it keeps setting on fire, you want one? Does anyone out there know why a whip crash? Raise your hand, you know why a whip crash? Anybody at all? Yes, you in the hat. Breaking the sound barrier. That's correct, give a round of applause. That's right, you need a full whip crack. It's a sonic boom, the end of the whip, going faster than the speed of sound. And for thousands of years, mankind has used the crack of a whip to drive chariots, tame wild animals, aim and scare away evil demons. That's why I never see my ex-girlfriend. Still got dark. Now, whip also goes fast enough that it can break bone, but not everyone believes that. So hands together if you think a whip could break bone. Not everyone applauded. At least hold your hand up. This is called Darwinism. First, I'm kidding. Yeah, keep your hand down. I'm not going to whip another kid. Sheesh. Hi there, other kid. Yeah, hold up that water bottle. From the bottom. And what's your name?
Anna.
Anna. Okay, hold up a little bit higher. There we go. All right, Anna. I will unscrew the cap from that water bottle. Yeah, long live the dad joke. And there's your bottle back. I'm gonna borrow your bottle cap for a trick later in the show. You might even get it back. In my 30-year whip career, I've been on the Travel Channel, the Discovery Channel, the History Channel, the Science Channel, the Steve Harvey Show, Conan O'Brien, the Gong Show, and America's Got Talent. With a resume like that, you might be wondering, what am I doing here? Well, my credit score is not that good. We'll go around, outside, behind the back, up into the air, and armpit. Behind the back again, then around the neck, and under the leg. All of that usually gets
a bigger round of applause.
Woo! I know. I am also surprised. I learned that from watching Magic Mike. Woo! That first was the theme song for Robot Chicken. Now, this next trick, brand new for the season. I learned it on my last trip to Australia. I'm the only one outside of Australia who can do it. Yay! I'm doing my best to keep it that way. So I'm trying to keep it on the down low, so I do see a few people with cameras off. So if you have your cameras off, please, for this next trick, do not take video. Do not post that video on the internet. And whatever you do, do not write in the description, Adam Crack performing at the Texas Renaissance Festival. Renaissance is spelled R-E-N-A-I-S-S-A-N-C. Tag me in the video. It's reverse psychology. Put your phone back up. This trick is called Upside Down and Backwards. Woo! I know. I think this pose looks cool, but no one ever takes this picture. Okay, all of you ready to see something dangerous? Yeah! See, very well, that'll need another small volunteer from the audience, about the smallest, cutest, most adorable kid we can get to come up here of his or her own free will, maybe with someone with a modicum of focus and their focus. And see, so far we've got two kids. I believe one is dressed as a washing well wench this morning, is that right? There's more kids than you here. I know it's hard to figure out, but other kids. Alright, let's see. Not too many kids are gone here. Let's just walk around. Maybe I'm stuck with a Harry Potter kid. I don't know. Let's see. Alright. Sure, we'll go with that kid. Come on up here. Hi, I'm a young person. I'm Whatever. What's your name? Vivian. Make some noise for Vivian, everybody. Yeah. Alright, Vivian. Are you having a good day so far? That's about to change. All right, yeah, you sound like that. All right, don't be scared of me. Any resemblance I have to Voldemort is coincidental. All right, Vivian. So, I got into whip cracking because of one man named Indiana Jones. Can I get some love for Indiana Jones? But before we begin, the story of Indiana Jones doesn't really fit into the theme of the Renaissance. You want to hear stories about King Arthur and Camelot, Robin Hood, or William Tell? Vivian, have you ever heard of William Tell? That's good. Tilt your head back just a little bit. No, other way? No, that way's fine. Yeah, there, other way. Back. Put your, look up. There, okay. No, I'm kidding! I can't do that to you. We are not in Florida. But I like how your parents didn't try to stop it. They just got the camera out. No, Vivian, I'm kidding. The Renaissance is not about scaring little kids. It's about having a good time, trying something new. So Vivian, to that end, Vivian, for thousands of years, the whip has been a symbol of power and authority in the hands of lion tamers, ringmasters, and even the pharaohs of Egypt. And now, Vivian, I hand the whip to you. The Harry Potter kid wants you to do it. I don't want to do it? Okay, Vivian, let me give you some basic instruction so we both make it out of this alive. It's not as hard as you think it is. All right, Vivian, here's all you got to do. What you're going to do is you're going to fish out the gauchos in Argentina, put out candles with their whip, grab the whip by the end of the handle, you're just going to swing it over your head, roll your wrist, try not to hit your antenna, just swing it around your head, and then you're going to go above the target, and down into the target. Just keep swinging until you hit something. Why don't you want to, are you worried about hitting me? You are the only one. No one else cares. You can hit me 5 times, no one's going to flinch. All right, does that make you feel better about it? You don't want to do it at all? All right, that's a yes, you don't want to do it? All right, Vivian, all right, go sit down right there. Harry Potter kid, come up here. We're going to need another kid. I'm surprised Texas kids did not want to do violence. All right, stand right there. All right, Harry Potter kid, what's your name?
Jace.
Yeah. All right, Jace, did you catch all the instructions I just said to Vivian?
Yeah.
All right, so grab it around, swing it over your head, and about this high. He's got it. All right, Jace, also, again, in case you, like Vivian, are worried about hitting me, don't worry, here's the worst that can happen. It already happened. You already knew that? Thanks, kid. Yeah, genetics had nothing to do with it. All because of the fireweed. Anyway, all right, Chase. All right, so I'm going to get in position. When I say go, then you start swinging. Okay, wait till I say go. Go, Wendy. Go. Thank you very much, Chase. And wait, Chase, not so fast. Because you only hit me once, you also get a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sticker. There you go. Go sit down. See, Vivian, if you had gone through with it, you could have prevented that. Anyway, it's finally time to light something on fire. Fire whip. I'd like to thank all of you for coming to my show today. At the end of the show, I'm going to be in the back of the basket for tips and donations. This is how I make my living. So if you enjoyed the show, consider coming up. Maybe throw in a couple bucks or a five, whatever the show is worth you. And again, for any donation of $10 or more, you'll get one of my new enamel pins. Now, I'm going to get the fire started by beginning this chant. Fire whip. Fire whip.
Fire whip. Fire whip. Fire whip. Fire whip. Fire whip.
Figure eyes on the bottle cap. And here you go, Anna. Peter bottle cap back. Remember, reuse, reuse, and recycle. There you go. It was only on the head of a sweaty, middle-aged, bald man. There you go. We do have time for one more stunt. Want to see one more? Yeah! Very well. So last year, I just had a Guinness World Record for heaviest whip crack. Y'all want to see my heaviest whip?
Yeah!
Very well. I know. So we got the record. I rode the crack a whip that weighed over 22 pounds. So we took a 5-foot steel axle and an 8-foot logging chain, welded them together, and tied 13-foot of whip on the end of that, making the whip that weighed 27 pounds. Whoa. Now, it's been a long show. I'm kind of tired. You don't need to see me in practice, do ya?
Yes!
Okay. Hey, Elise, have you ever heard of a rotator cuff? Here we go, trying to crack the 27-pound whip. You want to see that again?
Come to the next show.
Come to the next show. I'll do one more quick one. Another record I set a few years ago was the most whip cracks in the middle of two whips, 646. Here's a fast side to go to set that record. Can you sleep? Not really, everybody. Thank you. I'll be right back here. Yeah, if you like to pin, it's only just send me $10 and say pin, please. Don't worry about the line, I'll wait. You want a pin? Two pins, here you go.